Beach volleyball is a sport that has two people on either side of the net. It's an 8 by 8 meter court on each side of the net, and the basic objective is to use the skills of volleyball, including serving, digging, setting and spiking and blocking, to try and get the ball onto the sand on your opponent's side of the court. I believe that beach volleyball started in the Olympic program in 1996 in Atlanta. I think that being an Olympic sport is something that really solidifies a sport on the world stage, and I think that the beauty of being able to compete in the Olympic Games is such a high aspiration for so many athletes around the world that it only increases the level of competition and the quality of athletes that are going to go and seek out to reach that goal. My first experience of watching beach volleyball really didn't come about until the Sydney Olympic Games. I competed in the Sydney Olympic Games as an indoor volleyballer, and obviously for Australia it was a really exciting games for beach volleyball, with Natalie Cook and Kerry Potter taking out the gold medals. So my introduction was a very happy one into the sport as an Australian athlete. I knew that the girls that played it seemed like they were pretty cool, they had really good tans and things like that, so I was always a little bit envious of the lifestyle that they led following the world tour around and getting so many opportunities to compete, whereas in the indoor you do a lot more training building up to single tournaments. So I thought that side of it was pretty interesting, but definitely a sport that keeps you really fit. So all the athletes that I came across that were beach volleyballers, they just looked in incredible shape. Historically, the United States of America and Brazil have always been at the top of the tables with competitions throughout the year. Obviously, Australia had some success at the Olympic level, but again, you'll see a lot of Brazilian and American teams competing for the medals at the Olympic Games. More and more so, there's teams from Europe that are becoming highly competitive. At the moment, in the women's game, Germany is very, very competitive, and they've got a lot of teams, I think four teams, that are inside the top 10 in the world. It's always a little bit challenging for beach volleyball with perceptions because of the nature of beach culture and also the nature of playing sport in a bikini. So there is always a little bit of that stigma associated with the sport being something that's maybe considered sexy. I think that anybody who's tried it definitely comes to me with a different observation, and that's how challenging it is and how physical of a sport it is. The more that time goes on and the more competitive that beach volleyball becomes, you'll see that the professionalism around the sport is getting greater and greater. You'll see more teams doing video scouting, performance analysis, using physiologists and strength and conditioning to really optimise the physicality on the court. So I think there's a lot of elements there that are making the sport more refined, and you see a lot more teams coming out and being able to have longer matches, closer matches, more physical games, and I think that makes beach volleyball more and more exciting sport to watch. The more that we travel around, and especially in Europe, you find that more and more people are actually becoming familiar with the great athletes of the sport. So rather than just being about what it looks like, it's about some of the pairs and the individual athletes who are really achieving at a high level in the sport, and the competitive nature of it is really growing all the time, and I think that's making it more perhaps like tennis in that sense, where you can track your favourite athletes and follow them around the Grand Slams on the World Tour. I hope to see beach volleyball continue to evolve in the level of professionalism. I really enjoy being able to be a full-time athlete, and it's such a gift to be able to pursue your goals and dreams as well as making a living at the same time. So any athlete will tell you, if they're able to go out and do what they do and not have to go home and have a part-time job to support themselves, then you're considered one of the lucky ones. And I would love to see, as I mentioned earlier, in terms of beach volleyball being run a little bit similarly to tennis, I'd love to see it continue in that direction, where the Grand Slams are really coveted items, and they're something that, you know, can bring you a lot of wealth and success and notoriety within your sport by gaining success in that arena.